Mar Benjamín Netanyahu, Begeberet Sara Netanyahu, Brujima Baim, Bekabot Bishilenu, Shatempo, Animas Minotja, Las Yetes de Barim.
תודה לך, משה רומנו, תודה לך, אריאל הופמן, תודה לך, השגריר שלנו, יונתן פלד. אתם מבינים אותי? שלום. שלום בירושלים, הבירה המאוחדת של עם ישראל, וכך את ישראל. Told that there's a translator. What do you prefer, Hebrew or English? Lo shamati. Yadayim. Kama rotzim ivrit? Kama rotzim anglit? Okay, we'll do it. Chetzi chetzi. Sarah ואני מאוד שמחים להיות יחד עם המשלחת שלנו, איתכם כאן. ושוחחנו כאן עכשיו. אנחנו מאוד נרגשים. אנחנו אוהבים אתכם. תודה רבה לכם. על כל התמיכה במדינת ישראל. ועל היותכם. You know, you can be ambassadors for peace. You know why? Obviously. You've made peace between the Jews of Haleb and the Jews of Damascus. And European Jews and Turkish Jews. It's an amazing achievement. ואתם נותנים חינוך יהודי לילדים שלכם. איזה ילדים חמודים. ילדים וילדות. תודה לכם. חמודים וחמודות. תודה. שלום לכם. יש פה נשמה. There's a Jewish heart here. A Jewish soul. You feel it. I feel it. And I know how united you are in supporting the state of Israel. This is a great moment. The Bikur Histori. Hard to believe, but for the first time in 70 years, since the establishment of the state, that an Israeli prime minister is visiting Mexico and Latin America. I want to make you a promise. It won't take another 70 years for the next visit, for sure. This has been a wonderful visit. I've had extraordinary conversations with President Peña Nieto. Extraordinary. And it marks a closing of ranks between Israel and Mexico with a determination to seize the future for our peoples, and Israel and Mexico together can do a lot more than Israel and Mexico separately. We recognize it. We also know that you are a human bridge between our two countries. And we rely on you to take part in many of the programs that we have in mind. But there is a bigger change. ישבתי פה, הסתכלתי על הציור המדהים הזה, וראיתי את ההיסטוריה היהודית פרוסה לפנינו. So you have in this mural a depiction of our history. Now, that history began with Abraham and continued when Moses took us out of bondage in Egypt. And then we came and established our people and our nation in our historic homeland. This much, now you can applaud, this was a great achievement. We stayed in our land for about 2,000 years. 2,000 years. We are a people almost 4,000 years old. There is a fundamental change that took place when we were exiled from our land. And it's important to understand it, because it explains how all these communities came here to Mexico. It's a fundamental change in the history of the Jews and in the way the Jews were perceived by others and by themselves. The greatest thing that people knew in antiquity about the Jewish people is that they weren't a big people, they weren't a large people. They had faith, they had spirit, they had a belief in God, in a single God, and they were absolutely determined to defend themselves against those who would deprive them of their freedom and deprive them of their faith. This was the picture of the Jews in antiquity. We would fight for our freedom. We would fight for our faith. And if somebody tried to interfere, to suppress our religion, we fought back. We didn't always win. We lost. Sometimes we won with the Maccabees. Sometimes we lost. But if there's something that characterized the Jew in antiquity, it was that we produced great heroes. You know some of them. Joshua, Samson, Gideon, King David, the Maccabees, Bar Kokhba. For many, many generations, the Jews were a people who would resist the attempt to deprive them of their rights, of their freedom, of their faith, of their lives. Until we lost our land. And when we lost our land and we were dispersed, first, we were deprived of self-government. Secondly, we were deprived of the right to bear arms. Third, we were deprived of the right to complain about the attacks against us. Fourth, we were deprived of our faith in many places. This is what happened century by century. The Jews changed, or so people thought. And with the loss of our independence came a tremendous misfortune that did not befall any other people in history. And it followed century after century in the Middle Ages, in North Africa, in Europe. First, the Jews of York in England were exiled. Then all of the Jewish community in England, exiled. Then the Jewish community in Spain, exiled, expelled. Then the Jews of Ukraine in the 17th century with bayonets, destroyed one-third, almost 1 million Jews. And then the pogroms in the 19th century and in the 20th century, culminating in the greatest pogrom of all. And the Jew began to be perceived as something else. The wandering Jew. The Jew who at best could summon pity. At best, sometimes ridicule. And in any case, there was no hope for the Jewish people, because as this cascade of tragedies grew and grew and grew, it was clear that the Jews had no future. Right? Wrong! Absolutely wrong! You know why? Because we had another Moses. Here's there. Right there. You see him? That's it, Herzog. We had another Moses. And he said the Jews can reconstitute their control over their destiny. They can control their lives. They can change their history. They can change their future. They can change it if they found a Jewish state. And when they'll create a Jewish state, they'll change the position and condition and self-perception of the Jewish communities outside the Jewish state. Because now the Jews would have a choice. A choice. Everyone. But first we have to establish a state. And against all odds, against all the odds of history and the laws of history, we succeeded. We came back to our ancestral homeland. We built a state. We built an army. You know, when Herzl spoke about an army, a Jewish army, 120 years ago, they thought he was absolutely crazy. He said, no, we'd have a great army. We'd have a great economy. We'd have scientists. We'd have technologists. We would become a beacon to many, many nations. This is what he said. This is what we did. Now look at the great transformation. Look at the great transformation that has been possible for the Jewish people and only for the Jewish people. I visit Rome on occasion. And when we are there, Sarah and I always try to visit the Arch of Titus. And you know, when I stand there, I look at the Romans carrying the menorah from our temple. I think, well, you know, this happened to other peoples too. There were many peoples that lived in antiquity, were conquered, dispersed. You know what happened to them? They disappeared. But only the Jews, stuck to the idea of coming back. And each year, in North Africa, or in Yemen, or in Germany, they said, Lashana Aba'a Birushalayim. Lashana Aba'a Birushalayim Abnuya. This is what we said, generation after generation. So when we came back, and we performed this miracle, the whole world now looks at the Jewish people differently. I go around now to 6 continents. In 1 year, I've been to 6 continents. They admire the Jewish state. They admire Tzahal, the government of Israel, the defense forces of Israel, the technology of Israel, the economy of Israel. It summons universal admiration. We have changed our fate. We have re-seized control of our destiny. And you know, I remember this great change when I was a soldier in our army. When I used to trek, there are a lot of Israelis who come here after the army and they do the South American and Central American trek. It's unbelievable. They walk thousands of miles, thousands of kilometers in the army, and then they come here to walk many more thousands of kilometers. But I remember those treks in the army, and I remember that on many occasions you come to the end of a long day's journey, your body is aching, you're covered in sweat, and I remember one evening, one night, when we came and we were at the foothills of Masada, and I looked up at that cliff where our rebellion was finally crushed and the beginning of our exile started. And I looked up at those cliffs and I said, we've come back. The Jewish people are back. We are back with our country. We'll never give it up again. And we will unite the Jewish people forever. We have secured the Jewish future and we shall keep it. With your help. Toda rabba lachem al ha-tmicha ha-gdola. Toda rabba Yerushalayim. Toda rabba l'Emdinat Yisrael. Toda rabba lachem Yehudei Mexico. Yesh lachem od bayit po v'gam be'eretz Yisrael. Toda rabba. Toda rabba l'Emdinat.
Volten todos a esta cámara. Rabin. Chicos, ustedes acérquense. Niños de izquierda, acérquense. Métanse abajo.